We're back to Ninja Gaiden. Apologies if you hear me chewing. I got a piece of gum because my throat was hurting. Welcome to Chrome Croc Industries. We're playing Donkey Kong Country 1, and welcome to Chrome Croc Industries, where the questions are hot and the wings are even hotter. And Oil Drum Alley is infamous for having secrets inside secrets. Literally. Don't mind if I do. Delicious. So how's everybody doing today? I've been playing this game I've been playing this game on my 3DS that I bought like 8 years ago and never really sunk my teeth into. It's called Adventure Bar Story. You can buy it for like $3 on the Google store for I fucked that up. Hang on. I need to die. I need to start that. I actually need to start that exact bonus area over. Believe it or not. Because that bonus area is where it is. There is another secret hidden inside that bonus. Yes, I'm serious. I wish I was kidding. Anyway. Yes, I've been playing Adventure Bar Story on my 3DS. That game is like the cozy. It's like this super quaint little game. It's a JRPG where what you need to do here is get the banana. And then grab the barrel and jump. And bada bing, bada boom, there's your second secret. So yeah, Adventure Bar Story is this really quaint little game on the 3DS. JRPG where you go to like different dungeons, not really dungeons, so to speak, but these different areas outside of your town to collect ingredients to cook. Because you're running a bar, and like the whole game, like the plot is like about trying not to get bought out by this like snobby fancy restaurant in the same town. By, like, you know, making your bar actually worth shit. Ah, dang it. Man, I wanted that blue balloon. How dare you? I'm not used to this control stick, man. Like, it would be so much better if I was playing on an Xbox 360, but I feel like it almost would be. I mean, the OG Xbox controller is a chonky controller, if nothing else. Anyway. How long am I going to spend talking about Adventure Bar Story? Like, geez. You know, get over it. Nobody is as interested in it as you are. But I've been thinking about actually trying to do an LP of it, because I really like it. Quaint is definitely the right word for it. But it's got kind of a slipshod translation that's kind of a problem when you're trying to figure out recipes. Oh my god. Trying to figure out recipes in this game sometimes is, like, the most obtuse. Because, like, okay. I think you actually need this. Do you? Maybe not. Okay. Whoa. Okay, fuck off. God, these Manky Kongs are so fucking annoying! Because, like, they always spawn facing... When you get behind them, they turn around and their whole hitbox, like, moves. Like, the width of half their body. And it's, like, really awkward when they change direction. I don't know. Anyway. Yeah. Like, in this game... Oh, my God! I thought I was gonna hit that, so I let go of the control stick, and then I landed on it, but I landed so close to the edge that I slipped off a half second later. How stupid is that? You know, what a comedy of errors. Of error. I hate that word. Error. Like, that is just not a word that was designed for an English-speaking dialect. Who the hell could possibly enunciate both of the R's properly in that fucking word? Error. Like, that's not a... I'm telling you! Okay. Give me my P. Diddy, please. Thank you. There we go. This level really isn't that bad. As long as you can land on the fucking oil drums, like, you got nothing to worry about. Ugh. And this guy throws two and then three just because he's... What the fuck?! Ugh. I jumped on the barrel! How stupid is that? Yeah, right here. Just wait for it to flare up for a long time and then stop. I should probably keep vlogging, but I'm kind of running out of stuff to vlog about. Aside from Adventure Bar Story, like, who cares about that? But yeah, so I don't know how long the game is either, but I wouldn't be too surprised to see videos of that in the future. Trick, track, trick. This is the first conveyor belt level, and actually, if you... There's a barrel right there that takes you all the way to the end. And I have no shame in using it because I hate this level. I don't want that winky fuck. I don't want the winky token, man. Ooh, baby. Hell yeah. Da-da. Thank you, DK. Clap for me, you're good. Please. Anybody remember that from Nintendo Capri Sun's LP of this game? When he started, When he started, I think it was like episode 4, when he starts world 4, he's doing that bonus area at the beginning of Snow Barrel Blast, and he wins, and then he starts singing along to the victory music, but it's like the most awful singing ever. He's like, da-da-da-da-da-da, thank you, DK, clap for me, you're good, please. It's just really funny. And in the scrapped first recording of World 4 that I had like a week ago, I actually did like that whole thing. Like the first like 4 minutes was basically identical to the beginning of Tim's video. Not like totally identical, but like I commented on the same stuff. I hate these levels. Because first of all, I spent literally like a week straight replaying the second level that's like this, trying to find the secret in it without looking it up. Eventually I did. Eventually I somehow managed to, and I'll explain, and we'll get into that little can of worms once we get there. Cause I got a fair amount to say about that little. Okay, this doesn't matter because we're just gonna roll. Fuck. God damn it. Shoot. Am I gonna be able to get that? Crap. Oh, thank God. Okay. If you're wondering why I was nervous there, well, this game actually, I don't know if it happens in this level, but there's actually a non-standard game over. A non-standard life, you can die in these levels with the conveyor belts just by missing the conveyor belt. So here, I'll try and show you, see if I can here. If we jump on this and then leave, I assume it happens in this stage. Yeah, that's not coming back. Well, it doesn't seem to be happening either, so I guess I'll just quit out. That's not the last secret? Okay, I guess we'll keep playing. I guess we'll get to see the second half of this level after all. The second half of the level is really annoying. You have these guys up on these catwalks ready to drop down on you. It's really funny too, because like some of them don't. It's like I imagine that like all the Kremlings were told to like wait up here. On these cat, oh, right here. You gotta jump here, and then you can get to this barrel here. Yeah, that's all there is to it. That was timed perfectly. Ah, oh, put you back at the beginning. I'll play the rest of the level just because some of these things are funny. Yeah. So basically, you got all these members of the Kremlin crew waiting up on these catwalks for you to. Waiting up on these catwalks to drop down on you. But, like, there's, like, one that never moves. I think it's coming up here. No, not this guy. You got, if you're playing a Zitty there, make sure you roll, because if you jump, you'll almost always land on his fat bod. And Diddy can't jump on those guys, those big fat guys. This guy right here, he never moves. He just sits there. It's like you imagine that he got, like, cold feet. He's like, I don't want to jump out down into this pit. You know? It's interesting. Those are, like, one of the only enemies. Well, not one of the only enemies. Ew. It's interesting what enemies made it into Donkey Kong 64, because most of them were from this game. You know? The basic Kremlings. Careful. The Clumps, that's the big fat guys. I think Claptraps were normal style in DK64 too. They weren't clampons or whatever they're called in DKC3. Elevator Antics, man, I hate this level. Oh, I hate this level so much. Oh, I think I just missed a secret. Maybe? Yeah, I sure enough did. That was fast. It's a whole other ball of wax. Okay, so what we want to do here is just basically want to try and... I don't know if Donkey Kong... Yeah, he can. Okay. Wasn't sure if he could make that jump. This level contains the other secret that I eventually wound up looking up, and I have zero fucking hang-ups about looking up where the location of this secret, because it broke the fucking rules. Okay? Well, not really, but... Sure was obtuse enough to. Anyway. This level's a nightmare because of these fucking mini-neckies. I hate these mini-neckies that spit the seeds at you. They're so annoying. And they put these slippas here, the snakes, they put them in all the worst spots that seem explicitly placed just to make you wait like an extra half second. It's so annoying. Alright. See, like, right there. They wait for you to scroll the screen to the right there before that guy spawns and starts walking all towards you. It's like, oh! Okay, right here. Right here. What you have to do is get on this rope and jump up here. There's actually something up there, believe it or not. And you would think that you would do it on the other side because you can actually see the walls from a safe place here. But... No, there's something up here. And there is zero indication that you could possibly do that. You can't see it. You can't see it at all. It's completely invisible. Aw, man, I wanted that. Oh, well. All right. But yeah, that I think is the secret in this game that I'm the angriest about, because I can't think of any... It's not clever enough. It's not devious enough that I respect it. Like the bonus in Oil Drum Alley that's inside the other bonus area. Yeah, it's not devious like that, so I don't respect it. But there's still absolutely zero way. There's nothing in the game that suggests that it's there. You just have to guess that maybe you can get up on top of the screen in this one instance when that's never been something that you can do before now. It's like so... It's so bad, man. Oh, boy. Oh, well. It's fine. At least I know where it is now. So I will... And I'm never going to forget that. I tell you, that, you know, that's the nice thing about secrets like that is that you never forget them because they're too... stupid to forget about, and I write these down here, and there's another secret, and that's the last one. Take a throne, 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 throne. That wasn't so bad. How we doing, Candy? Stretch, oh my god, the pain.
Yoo-hoo, Honey Kong! Ooh.
An hour. Not bad. Not that great either, but not bad. Oh man, Poison Pond. This one, actually, I don't think is that bad either. A lot of people hype this up as the worst water level in the game, but I don't think it's really that bad. Because the biggest problem the biggest obstacle in this is these mincers, these spike wheels here. And those fuckers! God, I hate those guys! Because they always come out so quickly and you can't see them. Quickly. Quick. 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 What the hell? Donkey Kong, move faster, you fat-ass fuck! What the hell's wrong with you? Are you serious? That's as fast as you could fucking go? That's pathetic. Okay, anyway. I'm not gonna get by that guy this time. Face, get off my face. Yeah, the thing about this level is that, like, the main obstacle is these mincers, but if you at least know that they're there, they're predictable, so it's like, you know, you don't need to worry about it. And obviously, you know, like, the squids and the little, like, bite sizes, like, you can't really predict them because they move so irregularly. They're, like, weird to predict, but these things always move in the exact same pattern, so what's so hard about that? But those fucking squids! They just spawn and they instantly move at full speed! So it doesn't matter how slowly you approach. It literally doesn't matter how slowly you approach. If you don't know where the squid is going to be before it appears, it's going to fucking hit you if you're in the wrong spot. And there's just, like, that's literally all there is to it. You know, the mincers, if you move slowly, at least you can react to them because you can see them coming, but the squids are just instantly bolting right for you the moment they come on the screen. Such unbelievable dog shit. And they don't even move perfectly diagonally either. They trend further to the side, so if you try to back up, that doesn't even necessarily help. Maybe this level is as bad as people think it is, but it's not because of the mincers. Of course, I don't even know if that was why people hated the level in the first place. You know? Like, I really don't know. I don't know why people hated this level. I just assumed it was because of the unique aspect of it, because nobody ever complained about the... Because I've never heard anybody complain about the other water level, so it stands to reason that the problem with this one would be one of the aspects that's unique to it. But the aspect that's unique to it is not the worst part of the stage by a country mile. Oh, you know what? I think Engard's over here. Bastard. Man, I need to shave my mustache. Hang on, give me a second. Nice. Okay, that's immediately better. Just when my mustache grows down, like, past the corners of my mouth, I can feel it, like, holding my skin back, almost, when I try to move my lips to, like, you know, like, talk, just as, like, this random example of something that you might, that, I don't know, some people might like to use their mouth for. Nice. Very well handled. Are you gonna come back here, or was that, like, the biggest waste of time ever? Fine. I honestly didn't really want Engard anyway. I just knew that he was in this level, and I thought, hey, the extra hit sounds nice, but the unwieldy movement. I don't know if it's worth. Okay. Oh, I'm alive. Okay. Oh, Boshi barrel, a chimp barrel, a chimp that I earned. Yeah, this is when the level starts to get a little bit easier, I think, because you start running into stuff that's just kind of. Remember last time you were through this? You came through this level and you saw what happened with the mincers. Well, you know, it's basically, like, mostly mincers from here on out, I think. The odd fish here and there, just to, you know, cut in front and detonate. That one always messes me up. I think I usually do come through here with On Guard, but I don't even know. Thing is, On Guard isn't quite as fast at moving vertically because you can't paddle quicker by tapping the A button. Yeah, here, this is the very end of the level. All you gotta do is get through this crowd of fast fish. Yeah, like that little bastard right there just moving at Mach goddamn 10. Jesus Christ, man. Okay, enough already. Are you a bullet bill generator? What the hell's going on here? Okay, we're done. Taking a jump. Minecart Madness. Oh, this one's not so bad. This is the other minecart level. There's only two of these in the whole game, and this is the other one. And it's not so bad. Is there a secret to the left here? I don't know. We'll just play the level normally. Yeah, as you can see, unlike Minecart Carnage in World 2, unlike Minecart Carnage in World 2, you jump out of the minecart here, jump up there where the bananas end, and there's a bonus. Another properly telegraphed... Duh! Another properly telegraphed bonus. I don't believe it. I don't think there's anything in this level that's like Donkey Kong Country 2 had a level like this, and one of the parts that you needed to learn to do. Actually, I think that was I hate that part, because like if your momentum only locks to the minecart for like a certain amount of time after you jump out of it. So if the speed of the minecart changes during that time, you'll fall out of it. But like, what? Huh? What educated guess am I supposed to make? Come on. I just went off a fucking ledge. Of course I'm going to jump. Ugh, my beard itches. Need to get this thing longer. I don't know if I need to be doing anything else to get it to grow longer, because it used to grow, like, 2 inches long without me needing to do anything, but my memory tells me that since then, I haven't been able to get it to grow that long. Which I think there's like a thing, like your hair won't like naturally grow longer unless you trim it because what? How the hell are you supposed to jump on? How the hell are you supposed to jump on that guy? Because like the what? Huh? Are you fucking kidding me? I jumped over it. Sure. That makes a lot of sense. Let's get this in. Because I want it. Again with remembering that I got the G, even though I got it after getting the checkpoint and then died. So weird. It's also weird that you don't see these red zingers in any levels past this. Like, what's going on there? That's weird. Okay. It was right here, wasn't it? No, not yet. It's right here. Yes, I'm just gonna... I don't give a shit about that. What are these Kremlings doing here? They're just sitting in minecarts at the ends of tracks, looking forward. Like, are you guys okay? Do you need me to go, like, call somebody? Alright. There we go. I guess we'll end this episode off here. I don't know. I don't know what to do. Because, like, I don't know how long World 6 is going to take. But, like, if I do World 6 and then end the video at the end of World 6, I'm not going to have anything left because the final boss only takes, like, 2 minutes to do. So, I don't know. Should I go one more level? Do Blackout Basement? I'm not gonna lie. I really don't feel like playing Blackout Basement right now. So let's just not do that. Next time on Donkey Kong Country, we'll finish up Creme Croc Industries and then probably play like, I don't know, two or three levels into World 6. I don't know. Depending on how long I ramble on the map screen. Bye.